Well, people are going to start looking at him and saying, well, maybe we should put him in for game one. We'll have to wait and see. Let's go into the pick and ban phase now for game number three.
We'll see if SK Telecom keep up the trend of banning Malzahar first on the blue side, and then having it be responded to with Varus LeBlanc. There's the Malzahar highlight. And again, we really have to just try to get into the mind of what is going through SKT's head with how they're going to approach this series.
Well, so far the banning phase has come out as you expected it. There is the LeBlanc from SKT, actually, for their second ban.
A lot of people are looking at this and maybe even wondering, why are SK Telecom banning away the LeBlanc when Faker was basically like the Undertaker on it for a while? It was undefeated for so long until it suffered its first loss. That was a long time ago, but Faker definitely no stranger. But when you're coming into a series like this between two teams of this skill level, you think about a little bit more than just getting a specific champion and how that's going to interact with what you can do with it. And so LeBlanc generally doesn't offer too much versatility in terms of what she can enable for certain team comps. She is a very versatile champion, but that doesn't mean that it fits in well when you factor in this level of play, at least not 100% of the time. So they were going to want to go for something different. Rumble gets through for the first time tonight.
Yeah. And lots of nodding going on in that SKT booth as Prophet's like, yeah, give it to me. The Rumble has been contested so, so hard between these two teams in both of the series that they played against each other.
KT responding with Karma. Might want to just take away the Rengar, and there it is. There's the highlight. Lots of versatility. Not really giving away too much. SK Telecom might just respond here with Graves X, and the X being probably the support or the AD carry pick. Bang perhaps doesn't want to get banned away or have anything targeted. Might want to just lock his ADC in here. Against the Rengar and the Karma, Ezreal would be better than stationary AD carries or the control casters. Bar's already taken off the table. That would leave Jhin remaining on the blue side, who does have the Baron Breaker.
Are we going to see it again? The Talon that didn't work out in game one. We are. It's coming out. Pawn is going to give it a second shot.
Feel like this is a little bit of an error in a sense that you gave SK Telecom the counter pick when they wouldn't have had it if you just waited a little bit longer, but maybe anticipating that SK Telecom would have potentially banned away the Talon. The other problem with this is you have a very heavy hitting physical damage jungler, physical damage mid laner now, and what are you intending to do up in the top lane? Maokai already banned away. SK Telecom want to make sure that they get the matchup that they want. If they actually do elect to ban the Caitlyn here and then ban away the Ashe, it would end up reducing KT to using Jhin most likely. But then again, because of the amount of physical damage on their team, this might be setting up for Death to go on to Ziggs.
Definitely an option here. Very curious to see what the last bans will be. Ryze banned for the third time by KT. They just don't want to see a Faker Ryze. Not this series.
SKT deciding now on their last ban, and we were looking at the team compositions and the way that KT elected to ban. You might just target Jhin here with the Caitlyn, and that forces out Ashe. And if they don't want to do Ashe, because Ashe is not going to have the best of times, what's going to happen when everyone goes Ninja Tabby? You're going to be dealing no damage. The Talon gets gutted. The Rengar gets gutted. Ashe just feels bad. Yeah. Rondu and Zoman can even come out, depending on what champions are left to be picked. And so now if you're KT, you might be just forced into a Ziggs pick, because you have no option. What magic damage top laners are remaining? You gonna pick Nautilus here? Good luck against the Rumble. Are you gonna pick Jace up in top and add even more physical damage? Because now everyone knows that you're gonna take Ziggs.
Yeah.
You have to take Ziggs. KT 100% have to take Ziggs. as the final pick. SK Telecom now, if they're looking at this, lots of engage for KT. Lulu would shut that down. She's being highlighted. Another alternative here, even all things considered, could be Nami, or not Nami, she's banned away, Janna. Not a pick that we've seen in Korea in a very long time, but it would actually make sense relative to everything that's already been picked.
Zilean, very interesting coming out here for Faker in the mid lane. There's a lot of burst potential out of KT, a lot of dive with the Rengar Talon.
All right, let's
save
see
a life.
See the zigs.
Give it to us.
There it is. I fulfilled the prophecy.
Yeah. I mean, you called it. I mean, that's pretty much all they got.
They don't have any other option. When they opened their first three picks the way that they did, with the bans having been the way that they were.
Yeah.
And that's why I feel like the Talon was a little bit of a misstep, because it lets SK Telecom ban away the way that they did, and they forced that pick. The only other alternative would be Ashe, but then that would be a pretty feels bad man moment for KT.
Well, speaking of aggression, we got a lot of it on the side of KT, that's for sure. Not a bad chunk on the side of SKT either.
So we'll see how this match unfolds. Zilean comes out as one of the few champion counters to Talon. And wait a minute, there's another swap. Smeb now on the Talon.
Last second swap there. Smeb on Talon top.
And what I like about this is it's a red side Talon. It's a lot easier to conceal his roams in the later stages of the game, because if his bottom lane is getting pushed in, or if they're pushing so hard that there's no vision inside of the lane brushes, it's very easy for Talon to parkour his way down to bottom, get into the brushes, and create a gank. But also, it's very easy for Talon to run through the safety of his own red side jungle, assuming that KT ward defensively and properly with control wards, and get down there into mid lane. And now this is going to mean that Faker is under a lot of pressure to that Jace.
Yeah, it's going to be a very fiery game, I would expect, this time around. Very excited to get into this one as we look at just the last second here, the compositions of both of the teams before we do jump into this game. We have that Talon top. Very interested to see how that does against the Rumble, the very aggressive player of Prophet up in top lane. I hope we get to see a lot of that top lane on our camera by our observer. Either way, guys, this is going to do it for the series. Game number three between SKT and KT beginning right now.
I don't know who won that, Brendan. Those cheers were so loud.
They broke through our headsets, through our mics. Made it even louder. I think SKT got the better of that one this time. No bias, I swear.
That Samsung white jacket on Talon got knocked off pawn earlier in this series. Smeb picked it up though. He's like, I got this. Don't worry, I got it for you.
You're talking about the versatility of Smeb. Well, everybody was expecting to see Talon in the mid lane in that last second swap.
Oh, what? Bang.
Okay.
KT's starting this lane with a bang.
Even getting rid of the ward in the brush. It's going to make it harder for Wolf to poke against Mata. And now Wolf taking a lot of damage. This is before
this
the
is
minions even come to lane.
Yeah, this is so unnecessary. There was no reason for SK Telecom to handshake on this, but KT so quick to punish. Already getting Bang's biscuit. And Deft still has his two biscuits. Missed a skill shot though, so.
He was very accurate with all the other bombs.
Yep.
He's looking forward, putting on that aggression. Oh, level two hit here by Pawn. Faker taking a bit of damage.
Wolf trying to be as annoying as possible, trading aggressively. This is actually a matchup I've gotten to see a little bit of recently. Up in the top lane, the Rumble versus Talon, at least in solo queue. Obviously, this is the first occurrence of it in professional play. But again, it's going to come down to Talon's mid-game roams. Really like what Blank is doing right now. You can see that Pawn is playing in a pocket of the lane where he's safe, but...
Oh, look at that. The stun coming out from the Zillion, flashing away. But Faker wants the blood, and First Blood goes over to Blank. A fantastic gank to start off the game.
Really nice standard EQWQ coming out from Faker to lock that up. Blank and Faker share the experience, shove the wave in. Now everyone knows where score is. They know what camps he's cleared. We're looking at this one more time. That EQWQ slowing and locking up Pawn, flashes and even uses exhaust, trying to get into direction of score, but couldn't quite get there. And the other problem is because score was forced to come out of the jungle, everyone could hit tab, see exactly how much CS he had, and now they know what route he has available, and that's why Blank is pathing up to top lane right now, because he knows the only place score can go right now is to his golems. Let me be here if they want to try anything up in top.
You can see a ward did go down by Smeb in that front brush, closest to his turret, so... Blank just sitting around, as you were saying, just making sure that Prophet would be safe. We're taking another look at the bot lane where Bang still seems to just consistently be on low HP. I love just all of these skill shots out of Deft and Mata. You could just tell how good these guys are at their mechanics, at their skill shots, how they basically just don't miss.
And I'll be honest that I wish we were watching a little bit more of this, because with all of the pressure, well, hold that thought.
No flash here on Pawn. There's the stun and another kill going over to SKT. Not what KT wanted to start this mid lane, an 0-2 Pawn.
And Faker is off to such an advantage in mid and Blank as well. We talked about how normally he's the supportive utility jungler and he's given a lot of support to Faker early on.
He's essentially
and it's looking
like
aggression, but they're just coming up with kills, and Pawn keeps getting punished.
Bit of a trade here. Blank is like that your friend that you solo queue with, that you duo queue with, that's like a league below you. That's like, okay, I'm just gonna gank your lane 7 times and get you ahead, and you carry me. That's our strat for our duo queue. It's kind of what it looks like. I wouldn't be surprised if Blank goes back mid. I mean, the flash is still down here for Pawn.
And that does mean that he is that much more susceptible to the EQWQ combo from Zillion. Now, one of the things that we didn't get to really touch on until now is because Score picked up that giant minion wave in mid just a few minutes ago, it means he's 6 that much sooner. And so now they're looking at getting opening down and bottom. This is the lane where KT needs to snowball the fastest, because you use Ziggs's bomb or his satchel charge on the turrets, destroy turrets way faster than any other AD carry can offer, and then you just start rotating him around the map and blitz 3 turrets.
Oh, there it is, the knockback. Here comes Score, but he does get locked up the exhaust, and that is going to be a kill going over to Score.
Now KT want to get this turret. I am doubtful that Bang is going to be able to defend this by himself. They might call in Prophet, but no, not at this point. That's too late. So they are going to use the satchel charge. They'll get the turret. Well, they might not even use it. They don't need it. Oh, okay.
There it is.
And now Deft and Mata are unlocked.
It's a 7-minute turret here for KT. So while it looked fantastic for SKT to start with all of that advantage that was given to both Blank and Faker, KT using their strengths, getting ahead in their own way.
So something we didn't talk so much about leading up to this is the team compositions. KT, this is a much more aggressive variant than anything that they've used in any of the games between the two series, where this is really do or die they can't afford to go to late game at all. It's just not going to be possible. The Rumble will actually be able to shut down the Talon in the later stages. And in a straight-up team fight, they're so combo-reliant that they're not going to have an answer to the Zillion and the durability of the Graves, in addition to Rumble's Equalizer forcing them to split up and be so disjointed.
Nice bit of vision was put down by Blank earlier on, so they know exactly where Score is. Score claiming out a control ward up there, so he knows that he was spotted anyway. Handing the blue buff over to Faker in mid. They know where Blank is, thanks to that scrying plant. Bit of movement still down at bottom where Deft and Mata. Looks like they're making their way towards mid now.
Mountain Drake also the first turret of the game, and I like KT's decision to rotate into mid instead of immediately going top, and I say this because they know that Pawn was under a lot of pressure. This will enable him to now go into a side lane, have the 1v1 against Bang, unless Wolf does decide to just stick with him. Normally, Deft and Mata would probably like to just go top lane, but again, because Pawn is in the position he's in, they're forced to come to mid so that they can cover and make up for some ground. Faker, though, with the blue buff, Deft and Mata not finding anything. But once that runs out, eventually they would be able to get onto the turret.
See lots of movement around that Mountain Drake. Four members from both teams hanging around here. Oh, nice dodge. No shock blast this time around. Finally taking a look up here at top. Smeb trying to take a trade. Profit just on the run, baiting him into that turret. Getting very low, though. And in the meantime, you see Bang bot, so four members of KT going into mid and pushing that turret.
KT trying their best to keep the heat on. SKT, from their point of view, they just need to stabilize. Smeb now has a pretty sizable CS advantage up in top lane. And he still has his teleport. We haven't seen any of those Talon roams yet either. It's been a pretty standard island up in top lane. Mm-hmm. And something that some of the viewers might be looking at is, doesn't KT have the option to eventually transition into a 1-3-1, but that's significantly weaker on red side than it is on blue, because you think about a 1-3-1 normally at a stage where a Baron is entertained, and because SK Telecom's blue side jungle has the closest proximity to Baron, it makes it that much more difficult to execute a 1-3-1 unless you're really having a sizable advantage. Also, SKT also even has the double teleport as well. That'll certainly help shutting it down.
Juan coming in for the right side. Faker has just been very consistent with speeding himself up, dodging all the skill shots from the Karma and the Jace. Has Wolf nearby to help him out with some shields. It was interesting to me too that Prophet didn't teleport up top, and he missed a wave because he wanted to keep his teleport up. Play speaks towards the importance of keeping that up at this point in time. Smeb is going to take another fight. Here's the Equalizer. Prophet wants it, but Smeb will just ultimate away.
That's a matchup, especially up in top lane, where because of the long lane, Talon doesn't have the ability to do what he's able to do in so many other matchups.
Look at this.
Threatens.
We have three members top. Looking for a dive. Smeb, he doesn't have his ultimate up. He's just going to parkour over that tower. Going to jump onto Blank and force a Wild Growth out here. But again, they get a kill and maybe the top turret, but they will be giving up this Mountain Drake to KT.
Mountain Drake going over to KT is a pretty big pickup. If it were Cloud Dragon or Ocean Dragon, I'd say this would be a horrendous trade. But all things considered, they're handshaking on something that is very good for them. They know that mid tier 1 turret and top tier 1 turret are still up, so the effectiveness of the Mountain Drake in getting that gold advantage is so gigantic. And obviously having it later on, once they can ever capture a Baron or something, will make it a lot easier to get into the base.
Ooze and ahs from the crowd as Deft dodges all of the bombs. Still hanging around mid. Level 8 to Faker's level 10. You can see right now Deft has the most farm in the game, up at 122. Using those, his own bombs, to his advantage.
Deft getting his recall canceled a little bit. Now he's going to pick up Sorcerer Penetration Boots. Wants that mobility to rotate between lanes. You can see Prophet down and bottom just waiting for the lane to come to him. He doesn't want to extend too far forward, and he's doing this because they don't have any intel on Smeb. You see Smeb is waiting in the brush up in top lane, and this is intentional to create pressure elsewhere on the map using the Fog of War as mental warfare. Now he shows himself, and immediately you see the ping go down. Like, he is in fact here, you're fine, you're safe. There's not a cat and a man in a cape coming for you, Prophet.
Scary nightmares. Speaking of a cat, Faker still happy to just stick around mid. Oh man, he gets really low. There's his ult forced out. We'll stay alive. One fangirl really liked that ultimate out of Ziggs. Was really happy about that one.
Was she?
Yes.
Why do you think it was? Tell me why.
Hey, it does a lot of damage. I think that's it. And the push continues. Yep, going to take out that mid turret. And speaking of turrets, Smeb also pushing that top lane. Prophet just sticking around bot, pushing it into bot turret, but immediately recalls. Well, I guess the stun onto Smeb, but Mata is nearby. Looks like because he got that double stun, it triggered blank. And actually a teleport out of Prophet. They want to go on to this one.
Oh,
and they spot him, and they kill him as well. And they're going to deny Mata the recall. There should be two kills going over to SKT. Just about how long can Mata deny it? Giving this one to Faker.
Pick up the kill. Now they're going to shove out top lane, but this is leaving Deft and Pawn elsewhere. And remember that Mountain Drake doing work right now on the turrets. Deft not able to get too much, but Pawn certainly is.
Wow. That turret just goes down so unbelievably fast. Jace, even with just one Mountain Drake, if he's allowed about 15 seconds, can take that out. Oh, we have Prophet coming behind Deft here. He's going to force the teleport. And the jump over the wall, there's the cancel.
Another dragon coming up in just under 2 minutes, another Mountain Drake. So SK Telecom losing the lottery here in game number three.
Crouching Tiger, hidden pawn. The Tiger is up here in top lane pushing. That turret still did not go down. Looks like they want to jump onto Smeb this time around. He does have his ultimate available. No, it looks like it was down, and finally he just got it. But will get away anyway with the use of his flash.
Oh, Prophet.
Oh, boy. Not the best spots. He's trying to turn this around, but the exhaust will not allow him to pick up a kill onto Deft.
Equalizer. Not the most... Or not the best that we've seen, but KT rotating up to top. They're now in a position to even begin to assault this top tier two. And you can see that SK Telecom, they can't keep up. They can't stabilize. They might look for a kill onto Smeb here, but they know that this is happening.
Yeah, very nicely placed ward there to spot out Blank, and True Shot Barrage comes through, a lot of low members, but they will stick around to take out that turret. There it goes. Pawn again, even with just the one Mountain Drake, look at the damage he does to the turret and bang. And come back off to the safety of Mata, who's waiting in the wings.
Oh, and okay, I thought Pawn was maybe waiting for something else, but it turned out not to be the case. And so we look at all the advantages that KT have right now, and they're in a fantastic spot. They're up just under 3K gold, and they're about to be in position to get the Mountain Drake. They're going to secure this Baron coming up in 2 minutes, and they're going to be able to transition everything that they've done so far into getting that Baron and then begin knocking on SK Telecom's door. But they're going to be hard-pressed to really close this game out, and now that's going to be the question, because we've seen KT get into spots like this and sometimes even have bigger leads, but KT couldn't quite close out the game, and that's going to be the question here is now, can they close?
Wow, Rift Herald looking to be taken by SKT. They know that the Mountain Drake was just taken by KT, and there's no vision over there. Thrill of the Hunt used here. So they will spot them doing it. Are they going to jump on in? Doesn't look like it. They're just going to give it on over. And this will be given to Blank on the Graves.
Mid-tier one able to be saved, but look at Pawn. In bottom lane, constantly pushing in waves. He's being such a nuisance. You can see the itemization right now for everyone. Score, interestingly enough, has that dead man's play. It's granting him damage because of the passive, but it's also enabling him to just move through the map that much quicker. And now SK Telecom recognize that KT are only thinking about the Baron right now. Pawn might try to 1v1 Faker.
He's thinking about it, but ends up just using a Shock Blast on the wave, backing off. It seems like they didn't have enough info on where the rest of SKT was. And it looks like they're going for a gank on the Smeb again. Not the first time we've seen this happen. Oh. There is the Wild Growth that actually misses, and Smeb finally gets Polymorph, but there's the ultimate. They're not able to burst him down before he can use that. And oh, the Equalizer, though, able to pick up the kill, as well as the collateral damage out of Graves. Huge bit of burst damage right as he comes out of that ultimate.
So far, the Talon pick not really doing too much, and it's certainly going to be a hinder later on in the game. So right now they get all of the outer turrets, and so now at this point, now they're going to be forced to now begin to fight SK Telecom. I just said now so many times, Brendan. I just want to let you know that.
You're living in the present moment.
I'm
That's
living
good.
In a present, right? And Jace is the defender of tomorrow, but but Baron is on the map. KT have to somehow prepare a way to fight against SK Telecom, since SKT will just turtle their blue side jungle. Ooh. They're looking to make a pick, though.
Oh boy, Score, he is going to be locked down. The Ziggs ultimate does a crazy amount of damage. There comes the bomb, and you can see Blank gets extremely low, but they still pick up Score.
Score going down does mean that Baron is not on the table. It's not in the cards. Faker in bottom, two levels up over Smeb on that Talon, who also barely has any magic resistance. Really like the itemization also from Faker, Seraph's Embrace, in addition to the Rod of Ages. Very difficult later on for KT to find a way to pick him off through all of that tankiness, the active and the resurrection from his passive. Also, stealing away the blue from Pawn will certainly help in resisting any sort of siege attempts, or even Deft. They could have given it to Deft as well, who's on that Ziggs.
You see a lot of members now of KT moving towards this Baron. You talked about with the double Mountain Drake, just how fast they can kill that thing. SKT has to be so careful to keep vision there. You can see all the question mark pings that go over there, just saying, okay, let's be careful about this. They ping that, they lose a ward.
So interestingly enough, I'm wondering if KT actually accelerated too quickly. And now it's sort of like a rabbit versus the turtle where they ran too quick and now they're actually out of air. And the turtle's catching back up because without any of the outer turrets, with the edge that they managed to secure and blitz or out-blitz SK Telecom all around the map, they don't have a way to make SK Telecom fight them. And so now the clock is ticking and the turtle's catching up. And what is KT going to do? They're watching the game fall apart after they had played so well up until this point. They're going to look for something, but what can you do? You don't have turrets to force things to happen. Your minions just endlessly keep going into a black hole whenever you shove it back into SK Telecom.
And you can see that even SKT, they're very opportunistic. You know, regardless of what kind of position they're in, if they see a chance to get a pick, they will go for it, as long as they feel like it's safe enough. So they try it against Jace, but once they saw, you know, the Ziggs ultimate, the Redemption coming out, everything being used, they just backed off. And again, they're going for another pick onto Pawn. They don't quite land the slow, and even though the collateral damage does come out, Pawn survives, and that's a couple of ultimates there used by SKT.
Pawn managing to live there, only using his flash, whereas Wolf and Prophet both used their flash. Pretty big win for KT. Deft actually somehow behind in levels to Bang. Not exactly sure how that works unless Faker has given him a few levels.
It's possible.
Mountain Drake up again.
Wait, what?
The gods of Summoner's Rift are looking favorably upon KT.
He had one Jace burst. The tower just crumbles into pieces. Ziggs is there to clean it up. And again, that makes Baron that much easier to take out. Probably take it in about 10 seconds, if not faster. They've got everybody there. Prophet at an interesting spot. He almost has his equalizer up again. It's one of those spots where you can come from behind and get that surprise equalizer.
Oh, Faker. Might be biting off a little bit more than he can chew.
Oh boy, here's Rengar too. The teleport comes out. The resurrection onto Faker, gonna cancel that teleport. And that just keeps him alive after the resurrection.
Oh no.
Prophet is, he's going for this. You were talking about aggression. Well, he sees an enemy and he kills him. It's a very simple equation for Prophet, except he didn't get the kill.
See enemy, cast equalizer, Prophet.
Oh boy. Meanwhile, Blank eating about everything that KT could throw at him. Does survive, forces a recall though.
KT just don't seem to know how to coordinate in order to make something happen right now. And this is something that happened in previous games in their first series. They got very big advantages. They had complete freedom of the map, superior terrain, better warding, and a lot more flexibility at this stage of the game, but they couldn't do anything with it. And slowly but surely, SK Telecom recovered. And that's looking like it's going to be a very similar story unless they come up with something quick.
Yeah, so the question really is, what exactly are they going to go for? Well, they try to pick off Bang, but he is on Ezreal. Can Arcan shift away? True Shot Barrage to fight it back a little bit. As both teams really just gather up around mid. Only now does Smeb break off towards bot lane to begin that push.
Three Mountain Drakes. I still can't get over that. someone somewhere said, look, we're going to give you three Mountain Drakes so that you bring the series to 3-3 total. Perfect storyline scripted.
If only.
SKT actually a little out of position.
Yeah, here's Smeb coming in from behind. Has that Edge of Night. Jumps onto Wolf, the perfect Wild Growth. But look at the burst damage coming out of KT. Bang, will get resurrected there by the Zilean.
Profit.
They're going to turn it around. Profit with the Equalizer. Bang trying to do some more burst damage. Zilean Bomb going off. And he wants blood. In goes Faker. Misses that last one onto Deft. But he wants more. He's got the blue buff. He lands it. This should be the kill onto Deft. A little bit more burning damage. And down he goes. Here comes Blank, able to pick up the kill onto Jace. That's two now going over to SKT. And they've opened this up now. Blank looking for more. Score thinks he can fight him. And it's very low. Blank not confident enough to go on the chase. Doesn't know where the rest of the members of KT are. That's a couple of nice kills going over to SKT.
I never saw an old man move so quick as Faker aggressively pushed on into that fight. They're calling in the teleport from Profit. And this was SK Telecom telling KT, your team can't fight us.
Faker specifically, and then the follow-up there from Profit.
Score needs to be a hero. He has his flash.
He needs it. That's really what this is about. Can he get it? Jumping over the wall, though, is Profit. That's the third time this has happened in this series. And meanwhile, Smeb trying to take a fight here against Faker. Can he take him out? The Resurrection will keep him alive. And down he goes. That's Baron to five members of SKT. And another kill as Smeb bites the dust.
Now, with Baron, KT, with all their Mountain Drakes, it's going to mean nothing for the incoming onslaught that's about to be the push from SKT. You see the replay. Profit, we talked about this before. He sees Champion. He deletes Champion.
He kills him. That's it. There's only one equation for this guy.
Only one way, it's forward. And look at the itemization. I talked about this in the pick, Ben. Look at all those ninja tabbies. Look at the defensive items. You have the Sterax Black Cleaver on Graves because he's able to do this against that comp.
Well, with the home guard, Smeb, with the teleport, he wants blood. He wants revenge. He wants a kill. And with score here, I think they should be able to get this using that Seraphs, though. And yes, finally he goes down.
Huh? No ultimate? His ultimate, I thought his ultimate was up, so I was like, okay.
Maybe it was like 1 second away?
He was, I legitimately thought that he was actually just holding it until the very last second, going for a perfect play, ends up going down. So a little bit of breathing room for KT.
Well, we got the Clown Drake up next.
KT is just RNGing like gods in this series. SK Telecom, they win as much as they did, and they would have been rewarded with a Clown Drake.
But at the end of it all, KT can't pick it up. And that's four Drakes, so that's definitely a scary Elder Drake if KT can somehow squeak it out.
So I just thought about it, Brendan. The Cloud Drake is, so if KT does manage to win a team fight, it lets KT get to those inhibitor turrets that much quicker.
There you go. Even better than an Infernal Drake. We figured it out.
It might actually be, depending on what scenario presents itself.
Yeah, it's true. We'll have to take a look and see what scenarios do happen here in this game.
This reminds me of back in StarCraft 1 when maps used to be made specifically to bring down Flash and Jadong. And much like it, SK Telecom, through all the RNG, they're just not having it, man. They just refuse.
Yeah, they refuse to go down, and it's 11-3 now. They've taken control of this game. There was about 10 minutes there, or maybe even more, where KT was ahead, and they were pushing turrets. Everything looked very sweet. Their composition was working, and they weren't able to get anything else, as you were saying. That didn't do all that much damage. An 0-3-0 Jace, a 1-4-0 Talon.
Smeb in bottom. Doesn't even have teleport, by the way, which means that KT is in full wave clear mode. They do have the Ziggs. He does have the death cap. No more Baron. for SKT. They should be able to hold this. They don't need to fight. I'm not entirely sure what Score is wanting to do here. SK Telecom are the ones that are under a clock right now with Smeb knocking on Death's door. Remember, those three Mountain Drakes. Talon will light that turret up.
Looks like they read the recall coming in. And you can see the wave clear with the Ziggs and the
Talon's
Jace.
Actually going to move up the map. Well, actually, it might be just moving towards the minions. I don't know why he would do that. Potentially, I think he could have just gone for a flank, but it doesn't look like KT wants to take a fight currently. They're going to have to go into some smoke and mirrors type gameplay if they want to recover. And so we talked about how SK Telecom in the previous game would have needed Guerrilla Warfare to come back in, and now KT are going to be the ones that have to answer with it.
An interesting rotation as they come through the jungle. Looks like Faker has gone back home. He does have teleport. Just waiting for it. Loses blue buff. It looks like finally he will make his way out of the base. Speed boosts his way up mid. That's a pretty crazy amount of wave clear that the Jace and the Ziggs do offer. SKT can't even really get close. It's not like they have the three Mountain Drakes.
Baron now up in 1:30. It is extremely favorable to both teams, but SK Telecom need it that much more than KT in order to crack the defense from Ziggs and Jace. That blue buff on Faker.
Now Faker with the blue, he can begin to do a nice bit of damage here. He's super fast as well. He's got Lulu nearby for a whimsy if he needs to be even that much more fast. Oh, Smeb.
C champion, delete champion.
Delete
Brendan.
Champion, can he delete him? Redemption comes out.
Can't delete him if you can't see him.
Yeah, that's true.
All right.
He lost his sights on him, so he's like, oh, I guess he disappeared. I guess he's not here anymore. He picked, oh wow, look at this burst damage. Pawn is so low, he gets it with the collateral damage out of the graves, and wasn't expecting that to come out here. Faker ulting himself as a precautionary measure, also will eat the tower shots. And finally, SKT, they find an opening. Bang doing just so much damage in the follow-up there from Blank, and Bang
this
is
might be
popping
it.
Off. He is getting so much damage onto all these key members of KT, rather, and they get that mid inhibitor.
I like it. SK Telecom, they turn around. They're not going to make the same reckless behavior that some teams have made in coin flip for an endgame fight in front of the two Nexus turrets. Baron on the map. Score is alive, though. One level down to Blank. Smite a little bit weaker. Bang!
Look at this guy. He's pretty fed at this point in time, and he can just do so much damage, get Score down to half health. Although some other members of KT are getting pretty low, and now Smeb jumping on into Bang. Bang getting lower and lower on mana. Looks like they will back off for now. Pretty big wave up in top lane.
Like Elder Dragon 2.
30
KT
seconds.
KT made it to a point now where SK Telecom are going to be forked. They're going to be between a rock and a hard place. Baron, Elder, and pushing waves. Bang might go down if that happens. That would be disastrous.
Smeb's still going in. Oh, look at the burst damage.
Oh, no!
Blank now in an awkward spot, still doing a lot of damage. Lots of the SKT members now joining on up. Zillion ultimate used on Blank. He will not go down. But still no answer to this top lane that is doing now half the turret's damage. Health and damage, that is. Faker now level 18. The teleport coming in. I think KT has identified this as a place they want to fight.
Three Mountain Drakes. Look at how fast Baron goes down, even with just two people hitting it.
Uh-oh, Bang! He's gonna go down! Smeb, he found the pick! He's done it! Mana getting very low. It looks like he will survive with that redemption. Score getting extremely low. He does get the Baron, though. Prophet trying to run in. Smeb, really the member with a lot of health on his team that needs to be in there doing damage, but there's no one to support him. They take out Score. after losing that Baron. Now they're on the chase onto Smeb, onto this Talon, and it looks like they will be able to get him, just barely able to get that slow. Is Faker.
They got Score, they got Smeb, they got the teleport. KT can't stop the Elder Baron, or the Elder Drake, but they're not gonna have Elder and Baron now because of that team fight. Smeb found a crack in SK Telecom's armor, managed to get the assassination off onto Bang, but they still couldn't win the team fight. There's too many shields and durability available for SKT in an extended trade. And KT just came up short. Fortunately for them, Score did manage to secure the Baron. Blink not able to steal it away.
Well, had they lost Baron, this would probably be a lost game. But they will have to deal with this Elder Drake push. The very scary team. You can see just how much damage that Ezreal was doing, how much survivability they have on their team. Prophet, he's not going to stop at anything. We talked about his one and only goal in this game. And that's going to be the Elder Drake going over to SKT.
What the Elder Dragon's going to do is it'll put an end to the guerrilla warfare tactics, as now the damage threat and the threat of potentially ending the game will say, hey, look, enough of your split push and enough of you trying to move around the map. You're going to come to us now. And so SK Telecom are going to use it as a magnet to try to draw KT away from this push. But if Depth can stop the recalls, remember the triple Mountain Drake.
Yeah, and also with the Baron infused minions, it definitely helps out in stopping the push. And I think SKT is going to identify this and make their way back towards top.
Oh.
The tower's so low. Here comes Score onto Faker. Misses both polos. That's so huge. Faker dodging both with the speed buff. He's going to slow down Score now. And Score in a bit of trouble now.
Score.
Bang coming back. And uh-oh. He is going to pay for it with his life. And they only get the turret. 56 seconds left on that death timer.
The entire crowd for SKT was waving bye at the screen.
Oh, man.
Oh, so Score goes down. Death timer, not the end of the world. He'll be up in about 40 seconds, but there is an opening now. Smeb, when he does have teleport, does open up the possibility for him to just go bottom and light up that turret. Blank, not the champion Smeb wants to fight against. Edge of Night being used right there.
Yeah, pops it. Smeb going the opposite way with parkour. But you could see that SKT, they're trying to collapse. He's on a ward, and they're going to spot this right away. The Wild Growth takes him out.
You know what happens when Prophet sees a champion.
Rumble is the perfect champion for him because you just go forward. You don't turn around. The fires, they just
right.
always burn the enemy.
Right.
That's it.
He almost has that death cap. We've seen he's been holding on to that needlessly large rod for a really long time.
And that's another pick that SKT is able to get. And with 18 seconds left, Bang is just going to shift on forward. He is not scared of anything. Does miss that true shot barrage. Nice dodge by Deft. Will be able to go back and gain some of his health. And they do at least wait out the Elder Dragon buff.
And I got to hand it to Bang. He is making this Ezreal look like an entirely different champion. And it's almost reminiscent of Wei Zhao's aggressive arcane shifts where it's calculated. It's not incorrect. He's not arcane shifting into a position where something is misjudged and he ends up dying. It's always just on the edge to let him get as much aggression as he needs to dish out maximum damage.
And when you get chunked for half health as Deft, you're not going to be turning around to try to, you know, fight this Ezreal. You just got to run away. And so SKT, they pick up the mid turret, or rather the inhibitor. They were pushing bot for a bit. They're not quite able to take out the turret thanks to Ziggs. It just clears that wave in one go. It just feels like KT is just barely hanging on. They haven't really been able to put much pressure onto SKT outside of that top lane wave they had that one time. And the try for the kill onto Faker up at top, but they missed both. They weren't really able to get big objectives off of both of those plays. And ever since then, they're just trying not to die.
Looks like SK Telecom are saying, look, we're going to play this as safe as possible. And that's really just how they've been playing this entire series. We've seen that time and time again, where same can't really be said for KT. Definitely willing to make a little bit more risks for sometimes higher reward. And it seems that they definitely do just want the Baron, and look at how they're controlling all the lanes to make sure that, hey, even if we lose a team fight, you don't have a lot to work with. Now KT are put back into that position where they're gonna need find a crack in the armor. And so question's gonna be is, can Smeb do it one more time?
One time
SKT
for KT.
Might just say the lanes are good, we're gonna go for this, and never mind.
Yeah, Faker, even with the speed up there, does take that Ziggs ultimate to the face. Is forced back. And so safe. You were talking about it. They eat one abilities damage onto one of their teammates, and they're like, okay, we're just not going to push at all.
The Talon pick, by the way, we just got zoomed in on Smeb, really not doing so much. It did almost turned one of the decisive fights for them, but other than that, it hasn't really been able to put too much pressure onto SK Telecom. And much like Thor's hammer, I begin to wonder if that cape doesn't really belong to them. Belongs to the one team that did bring down SKT. Well, actually, no, but...
Crowd was going wild for Faker, sped up Zillion, dodging pretty much everything. And here comes Peng again. He's like going 1v3. He gets sped up by both the Lulu and Faker and the Zillion. And he just goes forward. Prophet, he wants a two. There's the equalizer. Can they convert? And he's still going in. He saw four members. He wanted four times as much blood, but they are not able to slow anyone down. And look at that huge Ziggs ult.
That's a smiley face if I've ever seen one.
And there is the Jace Bomb with the Shockwave, and everybody's getting super low. Redemption will help heal up his team. They will save Bang, but here comes Smeb from behind.
Here comes Smeb. He's looking for it.
He wants it.
Blood. They might have done it, though. KT.
They see him with the scrying trinket there. And now Bang is going on to Smeb. Fearlessly here, but there's the jump in. Lots of burst damage. Wild Growth pushed out is going to parkour over the wall. In this game, it's getting pretty crazy, guys. We're going down to the wire. This is what happens when the telecom teams face each other. A teleport now out of Profit. Or rather, out of Faker, sorry.
It could have been Profit. He only he goes one direction, but he doesn't have teleport.
He's going to land the double bomb. There's the stun. The burst from
Flank.
Oh, but Faker gets super low.
Step on the. Yes. There you go.
Nice. Look at that top turret. It goes down. Another avenue for SKT to potentially go in. But after they take out Score, there's no smite for KT.
It is so just beautiful, though, to watch the teams. You see them going back and forth, neck and neck, and even the little subtle things like Faker just stepping on the Ziggs. I actually don't know the name of it off the top of my head, but there's little Ziggs bombs on the floor to activate his ultimate. So impressive to watch, because in such a tense moment, they're still seeing these little micro opportunities, and they're capitalizing on it.
Yeah. And for me, the impressive part was Faker saying, hey, we see Score. Can I teleport in there and get the stun? Can you follow up here? And just like noticing the positioning of Blank and knowing that they had enough damage to follow up if he could land the stun. And then just calculating all of that and doing it as a team, taking him out and opening up the Baron is really what's going to enable SKT to have an extremely strong push here at 47 minutes.
Also, Blank has a Bloodthirster. I was questioning when he had the BF sword if that was going to go into the Duskblade of Drakthar, but he did opt into the Lifesteal, which I do think is the vastly superior choice, because he knows that the enemy team is so combo-reliant, so the Lifesteal, that much more valuable, don't actually need the extra damage from the Duskblade.
Look at Smeb on the map. He's in top lane. He could not help out stopping this push, so he just goes for the push in top instead. Bang, he's going forward. There's the equalizer. Mata and Deft are zoned out. Look at Deft's health. He goes down. Prophet getting that kill. Smeb looking for a pick. So desperately score from the right side, trying to get Faker. Immediately is going to turn that off to him. They land the stun, and they get the kill there. Down goes Faker at the end of it all. Somehow there, it looks like Palm was able to take him out, but here come the Nexus turrets going down. It's 4v3 right now. Smeb from behind trying to get a kill. Down go both of the Nexus turrets. Smeb gonna jump on in. Can they turn this around? Bang trying to get onto that Nexus, and he is gonna get it. Game three goes to SKT, and they win the series.
They send a message that KT couldn't quite keep up with them, even with the, this was the most aggressive composition that KT fielded in the two series, and it came up short yet again. And when you're looking at these two series, every team in the world should be looking at these series as the highest level gameplay that's been seen. And SK Telecom, again, methodically and systematically broke down KT, and it almost looked like a desperation attempt almost in a way, but what a series as well. You can see the look on KT's faces, the zoom in on Smeb. Talon pick, it obviously, I can understand it, I can look at it and know why it was picked and what it could have potentially done, but in tonight's game anyway, it didn't end up being able to tap into any of those options. And SK Telecom come out on top, they secure the fact that they are now in first place in LCK, and they have the head-to-head also over KT. Yeah.
Twice in a row, they take the 2-1 victory, and this should solidify their spot as the number one team in LCK and perhaps the world, and not a spot that they're